Okay, so I would say that we're pretty much past learning the very basics of how Toolbox works and understanding the software. So the next few videos in this series, we're going to be spending a little bit more time on our project setup and some of the things to be mindful of when we're working inside of the project properties. We're also going to be learning a little bit more about how all the project components are driving the specifications or the settings inside of the products. So let's keep this ball rolling and get into our next session of training. So we'll start off, as always, creating a new project. Now this one is going to lead into some drawing. So we are going to go back and draw some actual products, but for now it's just the setup phase. So we'll give this a unique name, keeping it consistent with MVU, shop cabinets, and job 5. Now for the project properties, job description, the job number, give it a phone number, maybe, and yeah, why not? And job email, and all the other things that you want to fill up in these properties. Now remember, this is going to be showing up on our shop drawings. So the more that we fill out here, the better, as long as we have those linked to what's on our sheets. And just by default, a lot of the stuff that you see here is already on those sheets. So that's why we're spending the time to do this. Next up will be in the project wizard. Again, just changing our default construction method, since my template is still set up for dado and screw. At some point, we're going to go through and make sure that we have our template set up the right way, so we stop doing this per project. But I like to start off at the project level first so we get familiar with all this stuff, and then we can start working on our template as we get further into training. Next up, cabinet size defaults. Again, don't worry about stomping on these formulas. Enter your value here. Now these cabinets are going to be at 35 1/4. I'm going to add the 3/4 countertop on them. Base cabinet depth, set that up to 24. Let's change our tall cabinet depth. And again, these are things that should be set up in our template. So Your common sizes or your typical cabinet sizes will all be set up for each project. And so for the most part, they're good to go, but of course projects vary, so we will need to change them every once in a while. And now for the additional construction. Now the shelves are not only for the adjustable, they're also for fixed shelves. I may have mentioned that already, but just a reminder. Changing the toe kick assembly. Again, ladder style, I'll do it for this one. As an installer, that's just the way that I kind of liked installing all my cabinets, was for the ladder style. So I'm sure there's a lot of different opinions out there on adjustable feet and ladder style, but, or even toe kick assembly per each box. Don't get me started. Anyway, back to training. Okay. Ladder style for the toe kick assembly. Now full top. If we wanted to, we can add a full top to these cabinets. I don't want to waste the material, so we're just going to keep them as rails. And the material options. If we wanted to change the direction of the grain, we would do that here, or if we were buying out any of the doors and drawer fronts from our vendor. The global variables, no changes in that one. We're going to leave everything that we have set up in our template. Go into the project materials now and make sure that we have this project set up with the correct material. Now, because these are just going to be some shop grade cabinets, I'm going to want them all just to be built out of some 3/4 plywood. We'll use some 1/4 inch plywood for the backs, but no melamine or any plastic laminate. So all the parts that are using that material, we're going to change. Now we can do that by grouping all the different materials together. But the other way that I want to show you is by changing this to material groups. So right click inside of here and now show groups. And now you can see that we have pointer groups with the assigned material. Now these can all be edited. You can also add more and customize them as you like. I personally like this method. I think it's a little bit easier on the eyes, and it's a good way to update all the materials for your project. So now that we have our pointer group and the current material selected, you can see there we have our 3/4 white melamine. So now finding our plywood inside of our sheet stock library in the plywood folder and assigning that material to that pointer group. Now, because there's more than just melamine that I wanted to change on this one, it's going to be for the boxes and for all the doors and anything else and any other finished faces that we have. Now, finished faces in this foundation library refer to doors, drawer fronts, applied ends, things of that nature. If we had any open cabinets, we would also want to make that change here. So just in case we want to add an open cabinet, we're going to do that. Drawer box parts also filtered out. Drawer system parts are a little bit different. So it's referring to like the Bloom Legra box and drawer systems. Now, I just skipped over the tall finished faces and tall open just because I don't plan on drawing any tall cabinets here, so I don't need to worry about making that change. It's just going to be some base and uppers. Now over to the edge band parts, and then to the edge band library. And inside of these folders, we have the different edge banding that we can assign to some of our pointer groups. I just want to turn some of this edge banding off. I don't want to have any of it applied to these parts. So select none, and we can assign that to all the different pointer groups. Now, if none isn't an option for you, there is another way to do it. I don't know why it wouldn't be an option, but just in case, there is another way to do it. So I'll show you. It's selecting that pointer group, right clicking, and then removing that material association. But obviously, if we have none to use, then you can see we can at least do it all at one time. Just another example of doing it one by one. See, the same thing works there. Now we have all the edge banding turned off on these parts. Again, they're just shop grade cabinets, so no need to spend the time edging all those. Now into our material wizard, and here we can make the changes to our hardware. You're only going to be using the hardware wizard. Cut part wizard and edge band wizard are empty, so if you go into those, you're not going to see anything. Don't worry about it. All that stuff is controlled, like I showed you, in the project materials. So here's just the hardware wizard, where we can change all the different pieces of hardware used for this project. Start off by going into our handles and pulls. We're just going to go with something a little bit more affordable than that handle rod. How about just a plain old straight wire pull? We'll do the 4-inch on our base, on our tall, even though we probably don't have any talls, but it's all right. Our uppers and our drawers. Now into the drawers tab. I'm not going to buy out any special drawer system. We're just going to make some plywood boxes for our drawers. So we'll change that to a wood drawer box. You can see the default file drawers is still set up as a meta box. There's an option in our drawers to turn them to a file drawer. So when the file drawer option is selected, it looks to that name default file drawers inside of this hardware wizard. And then of course the options below that only apply to those file drawers as well. Now into our locks. If we had any, we would turn those on. If we don't, the additional hardware, same thing goes for there. If there's anything we want to change, we could do that here. Now into our project specification groups. We'll delete this unitless decorative laminate again because we're not going to be using it. That might be something we also want to consider deleting in our template so we don't have to continue doing that here at the project level. Let's give this spec group a new name. We're just going to call it, plywood. Let's name it better than that. There we go. That looks a little bit better. Plywood shop cabinets. Okay. And back into the specification groups. So I wanted to point out what we're looking at here are the different components inside of each specification group. That's all the stuff that we were just going through in the project properties. And yes, we want to make sure we save all those changes. And before we add a new room, we want to ask ourselves if there's anything else that we want to do to this project. Again, it's all about being as efficient as possible. So default wall thickness, can leave that at 6. I do want to change my wall height for this job and work it with 8-foot walls. And as far as things that are going to be showing up on our 2D drawings, we can leave that alone. Now that we got our project set up with the correct specifications and we know that the cabinets will be coming in from the library the way that we want them to be built, it's going to make the steps of creating a work order and getting the project into production much faster. So in our next video, we're going to take it a little bit further by starting to add some more cabinets from the library using these specifications and going through the process of taking this job from a concept to something that we can actually build. And that'll be coming up right after these brief messages from our sponsor. No, I'm just kidding. I'll see you on the next one.